Okay. Why are you tweaking like Juice WRLD? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, sluts and faggots, I, BJ Soto, the Shaka Master, will hopefully beat this game, maybe. I don't know. Knowing my history of horror games, I get a little feeling of how close I am to the end, you know. At this point, it's like a 50-50 if I will beat this game in this episode. But who knows? Let's see how much we can uncover. And now we're in the hallways. Oh, this is going to be great. This is going to be interesting. Any goodies? I haven't searched for some goodies, actually. Let me close that right up. Just because. Anything to interact? Fucking newspapers. This door will not open. Le pitches. Alrighty. Enough with the fucking music. I think I heard something knocking down there. I'm just gonna ignore that. Ta! Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I had an idea about this fucking game so far. You know, why we're in here. Why we're in God's basement. And, oh yeah, we're doing the looping thing. Put the chandeliers off. The loop-de-loop, let's go. And your shoes are looking good. Will we ever enter the middle room? Will we ever? Who knows? Anyways, well, I was thinking that this game is kind of like my hell. But hellish, in a way. That's the hall behind me, right? Pretty sure. It's zooming in, actually. Is it zooming in? Or am I going crazy? Okay. Let's see what we got here. I just entered my senior year of high school. It's time to start thinking about what happens after high school. I recently applied for the scholarship. It will pay for basically all my expenses, including tuition, room, and board, and everything else. My biggest issue right now is my grandmother. We don't really have any relatives or anything to take care of her. Besides me, will I have to take care of her for the rest of her life? The answer seems to be yes. Her condition keeps getting worse and worse. And this is selfish, but I feel quite bitter about this current situation. I keep making sacrifices for her sake. Hopefully I'll think of a solution rather than later. It sucks that the fucking grandpa died and your parents are dead. Man, you had to do all this shit by yourselves. She's weighing you down. Was that the grandma? Yep. Was that the grandma? Oh yeah, she has a white head. She's walking towards me. But okay, why are you tweaking like Juice WRLD? What I just said is highly offensive. So for those who did not understand the warning, it's your fucking fault. All right. I have some dark humor sometimes. She's behind me, so do I look around and check the door? I mean, you saw that shit? You saw the fucking TV? It had a black line going over it right as the door was opening. Ah, bitch! Bitches. What did Toxic said? I hate bitches. Exactly. Are you down there, whore? You whore. Okay, can I open this door yet? No, I cannot. There's a hallway down here. Should I go to it? That's where she was, right? Fuck it. The Shaka Master should not be overcome. Oh shit, it's the fucking bunny. Oh, there's a candle here. I can easily open this. It's unless it's barricade to open from towards me, not open from the other way. Okay. Is that it? Any newspapers? Oh, shit. Shut up. All right, I believe this is my grandma. All right, let me finish what I was thinking earlier. I believe this is my grandma. I'm very late on the topic. Oh, I wasn't paying attention too much to this game. But every time I edit, I seem to understand more. So, I believe this is my grandma, and this is the hellish I'm paying for. Have I done something to grandma? And that's why she's haunting me? I'm relieving my own hell from my own selfishness, I believe. Because the more I read, the more it would seem that it's getting down to the wire. To a point where, thank you for closing the door for me. What's that say? Are you lost? How can you be lost if you had nowhere to go? Are you scared? Are you frightened? Are you without hope? Are you without God? That's a very good question. Yeah.
Are you lost? How can you be lost if you have nowhere to go?
I'm not lost. I'm just in a fucking loop,
are
bro.
Are you scared? Are you frightened? Are you without hope? Are you without God?
Anyways, I believe God's basement is just a fucking world where I had to relive the horrorness of what my actions, I'm guessing. Alright. Is our door open now? I'm waiting for a fucking jump scare. Let me get my shotgun ready just cause. Alright. Now I'm better. Hello? Bitch! Grandma, Abuelita, Nana. Something's gonna happen. What the fuck? All right, I don't know. All right, still here. I guess the more notes I read and the more that fucking TV talks to me, that's all I'm experiencing. You gonna close that for me? No? Oh, you're just gonna leave open. Alright. What we got here? I have great news. I was one of the recipients for the scholarship. There's a downside, though. I can only use it for certain colleges. The list they gave me are all too far away to commute on a daily basis from our house and the college. So I would definitely have to move. The problem there is that no one will be able to take care of my grandmother. I can't just leave her. She can't cook or buy groceries or do anything by herself. I'm practically her caretaker rather than her grandson. If I leave her, she'll probably wind up dead from starvation or some sort of accident. It feels like I don't have many options. See, the more I'm reading, the more it's going to lead towards that he actually did something to his grandma. Probably killed her or some shit, or even abandoned her. Bro, at this point, she's not your fucking grandma. Your grandma died long ago. What kind of grandma that's her own grandson? Lisa Burton. Oh shit, the candle's lit. Okay, can his door open again? Again. Ah, fuck. Why did this fucking closet startle me? Alright, on to the way. I'm ready. I'm ready, buddy! What do you have for me? Nothing? Can I open this shit yet? Behind me? Hello? What the fuck? Oh. I'm ready for a jump scare, though. I can't open it. What do I do? Do I just stay here? Oh shit, there's a note. Are you leaving me too? Fuck you, fucking push a pay! Ah, why did you fucking startle me? I'm all so focused and tense, and I got a reward. I didn't even read it. I'll see you later. Well played. I'll give you that one. Why? Why did that scare me? Why? I'm holding the fucking shotgun. You're pissing me off, Grandma. Stop crying! Alright. Moment of truth. If I turn a beat around, I'm fucking up. Turn a beat around. Alright, T-Raw Cash Money. If you're still scared of this game, don't be scared. Alright. The Shotgun Master will take care of you. Bro, why is my chair so fucking hot? The heater's not even on. I guess my body heat was exploded after that little jump scare. You relieve all the stress from my back. I'll give you that one. I'll give you that one. You scared the fucking heebie-bejeebies and beebies. Oh, no note this time. So what now? Look at this fucking TV. Can it talk now? Mr. Operator, we need some goodies. Am I right on the money? Am I ready? I'm pretty sure I'm right on the money of the fact that this is hell. But for what I have done, or I plan to do. Alright, nothing there. I'm still waiting though. Is that kind of gonna go off? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. I'm still ready. Hello? I'm still ready. Needs hammer. Oh, don't fucking play this fucking game to me, man. Don't fucking play this game to me. Oh, we're playing this game. Oh, shit. Wait, we could open these all the whole time? What if I miss something, bro? Don't play this fucking bullshit with me, man. Okay, we got it. Okay, we're in the corner. We're safe. We got it. We got the hammer. So, next chapter. Once we, it's just a cliche at this point where we grab something and something different changes. Nothing. I'm so serious now. Listen up, bunny. I'm gonna whoop your ass. One of these gays, I'm gonna whoop that ass. So what, we go from here? Once we open this barricade, we're gonna go to this fucking door? Enough with the fucking music. My chair's hot. I'm nervous. You know, if I'm this intense, it just gives me a clear sign we're getting closer to the end. And open sesame, motherfucker. I'm out. Why is that? Oh, we came from this door? Came from this way? Can we open this now? Definitely don't want to go over there. Can we still use the magic focusings? Hello? Abuelita? ¿Te quieres tacos? Tamales, enchiladas, chilaquiles. ¿Qué haces? Eh? Hello. Alright, so that's free now. Any goodies? How we doing, Grandma? I did hear stories about the fact that you've been staring at some things and been talking to them because apparently they're speaking back to you. So, is this Wall? What's his name? Wally? How's Wally doing? Tell him, how's his neighbors? How's his wife? How's his kids? How's his uncle? How's his daddy's? Alright, did we give him the warning of the fact that there's a sort of entity on a loose? You know? Like, you know, I mean, I'm not saying it's you, but, you know. Kind of you, but anyways, did you give him a warning about hiding his kids and hide his wife, all right, from the likes of entities, you know, from, from you? yeah, quit twitching. I already made a joke about that fucking rapper earlier, so I already went overboard on that one. Many people did love him. But to be honest, I have never heard of that rapper till his death. But hey, that's no excuse to the fact that I actually said something very mean, but hey, we're offensive. Dark humor. It's a lot of fruity people. Okay. Hello, bitch. Hello. How's hell? Why did the music go down? Where's the music? Where's the fucking music? Listen, bunny. You see this? You see this atrocity? You see the bullshit right here? You see? You see what's going on right here? All right? Grandma's tall as fuck. I'll give her that one. What is she, like, 6'2"? Is she 6'2"? She probably is. Fuck. Pointy ass tits and everything. Saggy ass motherfucker. Will she jump scare me or will she pull that bullshit where if I walk towards her, then you know what? Let's just stop talking. Listen, Grandma! And you turn off the lights. All right. Hey! You just wanna use? Is the transmission to go behind me? Is that your fucking deal? How about if I turn off my flashlight? Is that good for you? So you don't have to get blind from my gracious of a grandson. Quit twinking! I know cocaine is legal in Mexico now, but damn, you must grab yourself a fucking pound, huh? For fuck's sake. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the moment of truth, bitch, is face to face with the Shocker Master himself. Lucky necklace, lucky everything. All right, you whore, you wanna fight me? Bring it on! That wasn't as bad. I was hoping for something really crazy, like Sarah from the other game. I was hoping something more enticing. But hey, the company, what's his name? Irmus, wherever it is. You're doing a great job so far. I don't even know if this is whether your first production or not. But hey, it did give me the heebie-jeebies. All right, what we got here? We don't need our flashlights. It's bright as hell in here. What, we got newspapers, flags, American fags. What we got here? Visitors. Oh, do we get to talk to the screen?
James.
Yeah?
It's been a while since our last encounter. That was a lot of information to absorb. I hope you got most of it, but I'll try to summarize the best that I can.
I believe I got a lot of clear ideas, you know.
You were trying your hardest to get by high school while also taking care of your grandmother, along with holding a part-time job.
Damn.
At the end of high school, you had amazing grades and received a full ride scholarship. The only problem was, you would have to leave your grandmother to attend college. She raised you all by herself.
There's people talking in the background. Silence!
It tore you up inside, knowing that you would have to abandon her to move forward in your life. Slowly but surely, her condition kept deteriorating to the point where it was an extreme burden to provide care for her. You had to.
Is that why she looked like that?
Abandon,
you know, deteriorating,
move on with your life, or throw away a full ride scholarship and sacrifice your potential to take care of her. Are you ready to find out what choice you made? This is kind of exciting, isn't it? Well, I won't make you wait any longer. You chose to stay.
It's not like I can fucking leave for her to begin with, you know?
Especially when she needed you the most. She took care of you when you were abandoned, right?
I was given ultimatums throughout the shit.
Favor. If you haven't noticed, this area represents your old job. The one you worked while taking care of your grandmother after you graduated. First thing you should probably do is sign in. Enter the door to your left and find your ID card. I'll speak to you soon. Good luck.
Enough with this good luck bullshit, alright? Can I open here? Oh, I cannot. I just wanna like break the code. What if I leave when he's talking? Would that change anything? Nice bathroom. Usually bathrooms in horror games are scary, but this one's actually fucking clean. Shit, I can't even see my own reflection. God damn. I'm a fucking vampire. Alright. It's been a while since we actually seen, like, bright ass light room, a lit up room, you know? We were just walking down the fucking intermineral hallways of darkness, you know? Is this a keycard? Yeah, we got a keycard. Yeah. I don't like this, the row of shits. I dealt with this before. What we got boxes for? Please send in. Oh, shit. The number of boxes organized. 0 out of 50. What the fuck you talking about? Exit. Look at this exit. It's not making noises, but it's moving. Number of boxes. Oh, shit. We can pick boxes now? What the fuck is this, Minecraft? Guess we put it in places? Where'd I put this box, bro? Did I not put it in here? Oh, I do. Hey, toxic. Everyone. Doesn't this look familiar? We're stacking boxes. Most of you, the one you won't even understand. A bunch of you won't even actually understand. Oh, let me check in there. But this is a. This is something relating to another topic of toxic. I have a feeling I've been in this room before. earlier with those Dell Inspirons. Are you really going to put fucking 50? All right, guys, this might really take a while. All right, let's run for it. Grab as much as I can. Yada, yada, yada. Should we play some, like, cool music? All right, let's go. All right, so we matched the boxes where it looks like. And then...
James, are you having fun organizing those boxes?
In a way. I mean, that doesn't really, like... There's no difference of how I do in reality. How we do in reality. Ain't that right, Toxic? That's why I hate bitches. That's why we hate bitches. We all hate bitches. I hate a bitch named bitch. I hate a box named box. I hate a fucking burr box. Fucking, actually, no, that movie's actually good. Box. Put that there. What about these flowers? Where do I put these flowers? Oh, okay.
Are those boxes heavy?
Nope.
It must get pretty tiring doing this 8 hours a day.
Well, dude.
5 days a week.
Well, due to my physique, I can actually handle it. Especially if I go, if I do it faster. Especially do, I can even do it for, I can even do it for six. I can even do it for 6 days, 10 hours a day. But there will be times my body does give up because I would have to come home and make videos, you know? Well, that's what we all do. We do busy shit out in the real world and we come home and we make videos. So even though we're so fucking tired, we actually push past our limits to continue to entertaining. To continue to entertain our soda pops.
Hey, I think you missed one. Look over there in the corner.
Are you fucking toying with me, man? There's fucking boxes everywhere. Don't try to pull that bullshit. Hey, that's some asshole. I know I'm an asshole, but that's an asshole play. It's like when you're picking up snow and it's snowing everywhere. And you're going to be like, hey, you missed one. It's fucked up. But hey, it's funny. We all have our couple laughs. We're really just gonna stare at me stacking boxes. Great.
Does it get tiring doing this job day after day, only to come home having to care for your elderly grandmother?
I get what you're playing at. I just understand what the fuck you're talking about. You're trying to guilt me. This motherfucker's trying to guilt me. I'm out here doing my everyday job. Am I reliving the selfishness or what I'm doing? My part-time job, right? I had a part-time job, right? So this is what I'm doing while my grandma's at home. I'm reliving it. What the fuck? I think I just understood that. I could be wrong. Expected. But this guy's tone and his questions, it's like giving me dead giveaways, you know, in a way. All these giveaways. Yeah. Speaking of giveaways, we're going to do one, actually. Soon. Come on, we'll grab a box. Grab a bag. A flower bag. Cocaine bag. We're going to ship this to Mexico. Hola. Buenos dias. My name is Shin Juan. ¿Cómo te llamas? Te quiero cocaine. Where do I put this?
Do you ever feel regret? Maybe you should have just taken the scholarship.
Maybe you should just shut
off.
The fuck up. Enough with this bushy. You remember that guy from fucking, what's that game called? I forgot what that game's called. It's a raging game. Where the guy keeps talking. And you're trying to climb up the mountain with a sledgehammer. I don't even know what the title of the game's called. But if any of you guys would somehow understand what I'm talking about, then you know.
Think of all the potential you wasted. Was it worth it? Doing the same thing every single day.
Listen, man, everyone has their own potential. I have my own. Everyone has their own. All the rest of the soda pops know have their own. We legit have our own potential. And the life we're living, yeah, we may not like it. We could really make a difference. That's why here in the Soda Pop Productions, we make differences. All right, I'm wasting my life just to give other soda pops a chance to make them feel more than what they are, what they think they are. Make them believe. Like, show them the way. Like, you know what, Shaka Master? You're good at games. Yeah.
Are you anxiously waiting to get home, or do you find this job more tedious than taking care of her?
It was kind of tedious. I'll give you that. I'll give you that one. Anyways, I'll just give you, I'm just giving everyone an example. Like, look at me. I'm not making money. I'm wasting my time playing fucking video games, entertaining my soda pops. Not saying it's a bad thing, but in reality, CJ's a realist, and he does give us reality checks. So it may hurt us. But yeah, that's what basically what we're doing. We're a bunch of losers. And we just do what we do. We're just giving you guys examples of, like, what to do, what not to do. If you don't feel like doing this, there's other options. There's tons of options. Nowadays, you can easily get famous. You can even go on TikTok, make a random dancing video, and boom, you're getting thousands of likes. Whoa! You can literally make a difference right in and there.
It might seem like I'm trying to belittle you, but I'm just relaying the thoughts you had at the time.
Shut the fuck up. I know what you're trying to do. You fool. You think I'm a fool? I may be a fool, but not a fool. At least my abuelita didn't raise a no fool, right? We may have grew up hard times, hard shows. What does it mean? We don't know a thing or two of survival and struggle. All right? We grew up in a fucking hood, all right? Does any of you fools know what a fucking reef is? No? Then shut up. No, not a reef from the ocean. No, wreath. The things you hang on your door? Those little flowers? The rings? The ring flowers? Any of those ring a bell? Nope. Yes? No? Maybe so? Is she a little hoe?
Sacrificing the future for the present. Sacrificing all that potential to have a clear conscience. Was it worth it?
Yeah, we need closure. There's gonna be a lot of talk. There's just a lot of talk in the background. I don't know if you guys can hear it. But if you don't hear it, then that's great. I know there's people having fun back there. How many boxes? Two more? Dos más. Más dos. Oh, we're almost done here, man. We're almost done here, Chief. Oh, yeah, speaking of that, one of our soda pops got promoted to the Master Chief. Congratulations, man. You made a difference. You made a difference in soda pop productions. Speaking of that topic.
Oh, great job, James. Are you ready to start all over again tomorrow?
Shut the fuck up. That's basically our first day on a job. He said, damn, who taught you this? I'm like, I just know what I'm doing, man. Where the fuck do we go? Is there anything we should, like... Can we look in the computer? We usually get phone calls. Do we not get that anymore? Can we go to the fucking exit? Like this? I mean, this way? To the right, to the right. Yes, we can. Hello? Is that my office? No? And on the way to the next chapter. I don't think we should end this here. We should keep going. So, operator, what was the deal of that? Was I right on the money? Huh? It takes experience. I consider experience, all right? All right, we're back to the horrorness, I believe. Lights on, lights off. Nice house. Welcome home. Wow, we're actually welcome home. This is my house? It's my own house? Oh, shit. It actually startled me. Really? Damn. What day and age are we for us to have like this old school TV? Anything? Oh, shit. Is that a smartphone? It's a fucking iPhone or HTC or ZTE. Something of the sort. I can still see the finger smudges. Nice detail. I'll give you that one. That's cool. Hello? My house. Mi casa su casa, Hammy. Alright, knives. This is fucking detailed. This is awesome. You have a badass apartment or house. Wherever the case may be. That's the kitchen. Oh, there's all the plates. Grandma's been breaking them plates. Please. Nice basement you got there. Okay, open that. And on the way, go to the neon light. We got a hammer. Oh, and we take the hammer. Nice laundry. Laundry machines. We still got some boxes of our own. There's people talking in the background. Don't start on me like that. Come on, get up to the stairs. Come on, there we go. So, we got a hammer for what? Close that right up. I always close doors behind me. I don't know. It's just a habit. I feel safer that way. That's our jacket or grandma's jacket? Alright, music. Still don't have a reflection. Wait. Hello? Alright. Another basement. Is that another basement or is it just another way? Can't open it. I can't click it. Shit, got my own laptop. What the fuck is that? A MacBook? An HP Chromebook? Almost 10 o'clock. It's almost Betty Bye. Nice closet we have. Wait, what the fuck? Oh, it was a. I was gonna say, I thought I saw a shadow of myself, but it was just a shadow of the fucking shirt. Okay. Oh shit. I'm clicking this. Is that grandma's room? So what do I do now? Go down here? Oh shit. Oh. Cannot. And. I always think, like, when it comes to, like, stairs like that, I always think someone's running down the hall just to scare us, you know? Or someone could just be standing in there. That's also scary. The fuck do we do? Do we turn off the light? I mean, turn on the TV? Can we watch the TV? So books. Why we had that creaky noise? How old is this fucking house? Anything to interact? I have a hammer. But I can't do anything with it at the moment. It's not letting me click that door. I mean, I'm clicking it, but it's not letting me... It's not letting my buttons register. Can I click this book? Is there a note somewhere? Think outside the box. Come on, Shocker Master. You got this. Think. What else? Can you grab the knife? Can you stab yourself with it? Cut your own nuts off? Just like, yeah, I'm out. I don't have to deal with this bullshit anymore. Because fuck this place. Oh, shit. What if we could hide in here? You guys should hide in here. Oh, that's cool. So, what the fuck we do? We grab a hammer. What are we supposed to do? Do we still get hints? Options, hints. In my bedroom? What the fuck? Really? I'm so blind. I guess that's the one thing I never really pay attention about is the fucking sticky notes. They make all the differences. Wait. Let me close that out just in case something bad happens. Sorrow. So I barricade my own grandma? What the fuck? So after my job, this is what I did? This is what I did, huh? I just locked her in. Oh shit, no. What we got here? Clean up broken plates, hide kitchen knife under the bed. Check emails on the phone, nail wooden planks on the door. Turn off all the lights. Go to bed. Wow. Alright. Do I have to do that in that order? I believe so. Alright, what fucking plates? Was there? Was that? Okay. It was. Wow, these plates weren't here before. Alright, we got that. Let's get this knife. Yeah, we got a knife. Yay. We have a weapon. We can use it as a weapon. I mean, I want a shotgun real bad. Why did I need to hide the knife under the bed? So she won't, like. do something with it? Oh, yeah, that's hideable. Oh, yeah, that's sneaky. Well, it's not like Abuelita will go in our room, would she? The phone's available now. It's unfortunate that you have to decline our scholarship program. Thank you for applying, and we hope that you're successful in all your future academic endeavors. Wow. So, what's next? Torchlights. Wow. Get out. I hate these fucking buttons, man. Screw me over. It's all nailed, right? It should be nailed. So, if it's nailed, what do we do here? No, click it. Turn off the lights, go to bed. Oh, shit. Oh, let's... Oh. So, what, we turn off all these lights? Fuck you. Don't pull this pushy on me. Better be off. Fucking bitches. Go close that up. There we go. I feel more safer now. But not after this. There we go. Right here. There we go. Get through here. Turn off this bathroom one. Close it right up. Turn this one off. Oh, shit. And now I'm ready to go. We go to bed. And we go to bed. All right. Stop crying, dog. We're fine. I'm in my beddy, bye. What now? Grandma, it's past your bedtime. Don't you dare wake me up. I gotta get up to work. Is there a reason why we're doing this? Cause does she like go off at night? In the middle of the night? Did we caught her one time? And messing with a knife or some shit? So we barricade her? So she won't get out and try to do something stupid with a fucking knife? Is that the deal? Thanks for the knocking. Hello, who's there? Knock down. Who are you? Silence! Why is she knocking? She's gotta start banging, isn't she? There we go. She wants to get the fuck out. Abuelita got some strong ass arms. I'll give her that one. She's been working out in the gym. All that time alone in her room, she's been training to this day. For this moment. Damn, them games, they're actually working. Am I not gonna wake up? And she's walking. Where's she walking? Is she walking to my room? Is she walking down the hall? Is she gonna go to the kitchen to find some shit? Is she gonna break more plates? What's she doing? Abuelita! ¿Qué estás haciendo? Is she opened my door? Did she open my door? Is she gonna see me sleeping? Do you hear that? Did she hear it? Oh, fuck. Oh, she did open the door. Oh, great. Her light's still on. Can I turn on lights? Ah, oh, fuck this flashlight. Oh, goddammit. She went down there. I can't turn them on. Shit. My phone's still there. Where'd I go? Alright, we get that. Ah, oh, fuck, guys. Moment of truth. Abuelita. Listen. I understand you're frustrated. But sometimes you gotta have to be put it down. She got jump scared me? Oh, she disappeared. So what do we do now? Oh shit. Wow! I'm fucking stupid. Pain, are you full of it? Patience, are you out of it? When will the suffering end? That's a very good question. All right, we reached a chapter. We reached a chapter. I was about to say, we could hide in that closet, can we? No, get it. Close it. There we go. Oh, look.
Hey, are you full of it?
Listen, Pain in Naruto is a good villain. Good anti-hero. Good character. Shotgun down. So what do I do now? Abuelita? I go to my room now? Hello? Oh shit. Close it. My laptop. All these codes. .ini codes. Some shit. In a way. Today I found my laptop broken. I left her alone for just a few minutes while I was in the bathroom, and I guess she walked in my bedroom and had an episode. I'll have to drain my savings in order to replace it. She fucked with my laptop? She saw porn and she's like, nah, grandson, mijo, ¿qué haces? Ayúdeme. Pequeño. Cojones, pequeño. So did I go in her room? She fucked with my laptop. Why the fuck would she fuck with my laptop? She went to search something online and got made my laptop get a virus. Some bullshit. So what do I do now? Hints? Nope. I'm nervous. I'm more nervous though. Only because it's a big ass house. That's it.
Oh.
Let me be right back. And we're back. All right, so I had to deal with the dog. He won't stop crying. Jeez. Don't worry, no dogs were being abused. I just let her out of her cage. Do we go in here? Do we not? Do we go to bed? What happened? Don't freeze on me. Oh, I was about to say, don't fucking freeze on me, please. I said follow it, right? I did that. I looked at it. Then I went to the living room. Was there more to it? Was I supposed to look all over to the living room? Look how boring I'm making this video. Is there, oh shit, there's a note. Oh no, 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 that's been there. I'm such an idiot. Oh shit, what? Oh. What the fuck? Am I supposed to go here again? Hello? Hola? Or do I go down the basement? Well, not the basement. We're already in God's basement. What the fuck am I talking about? Basement inception. Well, downstairs. It says I can't go in a room. Do I go down here? Oh, I do. I do. Oh. I thought I was in her room because don't she have a radio? Oh, shit. The light. Fuck me. Imagine I go back. Hey, what do we got here? Oh, shit. This is my office. It's all in an empty room. This reminds me, in a scene of Silent Hill PT where, in a corner there's a fucking table with a bloody bag. I think it could be a headless, there's a head in the fucking bag, and it's all bloody, but it's speaking to me. Saying this and that. I think I remember the quote, the only real me is me. Are you sure the only you is you, or the real you is you? I don't know. Stop talking in the background. Silence. I did something against Speaker. I killed him. I murdered both. I don't know. I didn't know what to do. I had anything left to live for. The truth.
While sifting through some old boxes, you found an interesting set of documents that revealed the truth about your past. Your grandparents were involved in an accident that killed your grandfather and your infant brother. It wasn't your grandmother's fault entirely, but your parents couldn't help but put the blame on her. With no family or friends left, living a hopeless and bleak existence, your grandmother decided to murder them. With your parents out of the way, she could raise you all by herself. Her desire was selfish and evil. That was all you needed. A way to justify her death. A way to break the burden of taking care of her. Do you remember what you did? I'll walk you through it once more, just in case you've forgotten.
That's it? Not gonna talk? Can I go back? What the fuck? Oh my god. Do I go back? I do go back. Literally, I get to go back. Cool. So, what has occurred? Did I kill my grandma? I killed her, right? Just for killing my own parents. Well, thanks for the red room. Yeah. No, I'm actually used to the red light. I got a note here. Get the knife. Get the new radio. Get the phone. Place the knife on her bed. Replace the old radio. Oh, fuck no. What did I do? I seen some movies that had like a similar scenario. Oh shit, what did I do? I have an idea what I could have done, but let's see how it went. Oh fuck no. What was this thing saying? Oh shit, that's the same thing. What the fuck? Get the knife, get the new. Lita, I'm gonna do something very mean. I'm literally gonna do it. It's fucked up. All right. Oh shit, you have it all set out for me. Great. Alright, might as well go. There's that. Close that, I guess. Put the phone there.
Yes, I'm talking to you. Are you listening to me? I know that I might seem suspicious, but for now, I'm going to need you to trust me. Are you in pain? Do you want that pain to go away? I can show you a way out, but you're going to have to do exactly what I say. Don't worry, very soon you won't feel any pain at all. You won't have to suffer any longer.
Silence!
Quite a bit of pain.
will not be missed. What the fuck? And we just fade away like that. Yep, I relive my own mistakes. Oh God, what have we got here? Did we beat the game?
James, you murdered her. You knew about her delusions. She always talked about the man in the radio, so you decided to become that character. You replaced the old radio and then played an audio file telling her to stab herself repeatedly with a knife. You knew she was delusional and had episodes of schizophrenia.
What kind of degree of murder is
she
this?
Followed your instructions.
Is this considered murder? Homicide?
Due to her self-inflicted injuries.
All of the above?
Since all the evidence pointed to a suicide, you weren't charged with anything.
Wow.
You finally got what you wanted. You were finally free.
Damn.
You might be wondering how exactly you ended up dead. Well, for the first few months, you lived your life carefree. You actually enjoyed life to some extent, not being tied down by an ill relative. But eventually, that all came crashing down.
I got in a car accident?
It started off with brief, horrific, gruesome nightmares. Visions of her stabbing herself endlessly, blood gushing out of her wounds, flooding your mind with blood-red guilt. Slowly, these nightmares
came
into your daily life. You'd see her out of the corner of your eye, whether you were driving, walking down the street, or at work. Even though you killed her, she never really left. She lived in your mind and haunted you every day until you eventually couldn't fall asleep. Every time you closed your eyes, even for the briefest of moments, she'd manifest in your subconscious. Eventually, you went to the hospital and you were prescribed sleep medicine, but that only suppressed the issue. Slowly, your body adjusted to the medicine and you needed to increase the dose for the medicine to be effective.
I become a drug addict.
This process kept repeating until you were taking multiple times the recommended amount. You were addicted. Until one night, you overdosed on sleep medication.
Die from overdose, huh?
Right now, in this moment, your physical body is currently in a hospital bed, hovering between the thin line of life and death.
I'm in a drug-induced coma?
You're still probably wondering why you're
I heard of those.
In God's basement. I'll finally tell you who I am and what this place really is.
My Ryan of money.
God's basement is a realm for those who have committed great sin, but are still redeemable.
Mm-hmm.
The individuals that arrive in God's basement relive their own versions of hell, allowing them to reflect on their life and watch their slow descent into evil. Their resentment, hate, bitterness, and jealousy accumulate, until those emotions manifest themselves through atrocious acts, yours being murdered.
I didn't really kill her, technically, you know.
Your life slowly pass you by. All those opportunities you sacrificed. All that potential wasted. You became bitter and resentful. Many could sympathize with you. Many might have even done the same. You were hopeless, and it felt like you were inside a living hell. I am called the Operator. I am an entity that manifests in God's basement. I manifest myself in different ways depending on the person. My job is to guide the person inside God's basement and allow them to relive their life from a different perspective.
Sounds like close.
In your case, I manifested with
what
many
was going
characteristics
on here?
Resembling the man in the radio. Hopefully this explanation cleared everything up. You're still probably wondering what happens now that you have all your memories. I mentioned earlier that God's basement are for those who are still redeemable. Even though you committed an atrocious sin, you were trapped in a hopeless existence. Also, the person you killed wasn't really your grandmother. She was a shell of her former self.
I was kind of right.
Your grandmother died. died long ago. Part of you wanted to see her suffering cease. Your crime was both cruel and merciful at the same time. You are going to get a second chance at life.
I was given a second chance in life.
Wake up in a hospital bed out of your drug-induced coma.
Ah.
Learn to live with what you did. The feelings of guilt, paranoia, and pain will never completely go away. James.
Finished.
Make the most out of life and be grateful for this second chance. One last thing. Good luck.
Good luck for my second chance in life. Damn, that's actually crazy. I'm in a fucking coma. It was like therapy in there. I had to recap on everything that has happened throughout my life, before my life, and etc. Just to make myself a better person once I wake up. And I believe I'm awoken. I have awoken. I have ascended. I have risen. Did I move? Oh, no. Why are we playing Evil Within music? I understand his music's way before Evil Within, but at this point, that's why I know what this music is for. And every hospital, they play this song. I've been to a hospital that actually played this song. I'm like, wow. I guess the cliches actually, like, take their part or something like that. God's Basement. We have finally been in the game. Was it an hour long? I believe so. Over an hour, maybe? Damn. This is great. I have beat the game. This is actually a good game, I'm not gonna lie. Toxic, you actually recommended a really decent game. For fuck's sake. Holy shit, I give him props. I give him 10 out of 10 right then and there. Thank you for playing. You're welcome. It was a pleasure playing this game. It was great. It's well detailed. Good plots. Good of thinking outside the box. Like, I got no complaints. Nothing. The fucking, like, being stuck in one spot until you have to wait for a hint does, like, trouble me sometimes. Erebus. See, it looks like she's smiling. Damn. She has a long-ass neck. Fucking pain, Manny. Are we done? Can we go to the menu now? Hello, I'm a developer of God's Basement. You have reached the end, and I want to say thank you for playing through the whole game. I'm still pretty new to creating video games, so I hope the experience was bearable. Hopefully you enjoyed the experience. Maybe someday you'll play another one of my games, if I'm able to release another one. Thanks again, Erebus. You're welcome. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of God's Basement. Hope you enjoyed this. And Toxic, if you have any more games, or any soda pop out there, any games you want me to play while in CJ's absence, any requests of video games that you want me to play, horror, it don't even have to be horror, it can be fun, it can be awesome, and we'll see how it goes. If you ever guys, any videos, any games you guys give me, I'll play it, and we'll see how it goes from there. Is it worthwhile to make a series, or is it worthwhile to not? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, if you somehow enjoyed this video, leave a like! If not, dislike. Share this video with your friends. Have a great day, if not better! See you all later. I bring the light into the ground.